Welcome to A-Level and AP Physics. In today's lesson, we will discuss one very important past paper question on quantum physics from May-June 2021 paper 4-2. This question is based on properties of photon and conservation of momentum for an isolated system. For part A, we need to state what is meant by a photon, means what is photon. Let me explain to you what is photon in a very simple way. We can imagine that there is a piece of metal. Let's say this is one small piece of metal and the light is shining on this metal. Light means that electromagnetic radiation. We can also write down light is electromagnetic radiation because this is part of electromagnetic spectrum. You can say this is electromagnetic radiation. But according to particle theory of light, this light is not a wave. Instead of that, this consists of small packets of energy. So simply we can draw these square on this one. So E square is representing a photon, a packet of energy of electromagnetic radiation, or simply you can say is quantum of energy of electromagnetic radiation. So this is how you can define what is photon. This is how you can write down your answer for part A. Part A has two marks. The first mark is for quantum of energy. If you have written quantum of energy, you will get M mark. And if you have written then electromagnetic radiation, you will get A mark. But if you didn't write quantum of energy, or if you didn't write packet of energy, you will not get any mark, because in order to get A mark, you must get M mark. So quantum of energy or packet of energy, always you need to write down when you need to define photon. First of all, let's try to understand properties of photon, because understanding of properties of photon is very important to answer questions on quantum physics, and it is also important for this question. First property of photon is light consists of particles, and light particles we call them photon, as we have explained in part A. So simply we can say particles of light, we call them photons. So particles of light are called photons. So these are photons. Next thing we need to understand, the properties. The first property of photon we can simply define: rest mass of photon is zero. Rest mass of photon is zero, or simply we can say it is not defined in terms of Newtonian mechanics. Third, we need to understand the speed of photon. Speed of photon is equal to speed of light. So we can say the speed of photons in air or vacuum, that is equal to speed of light, and that is about 3×10⁸ meters per second. So here we are talking about medium is air or medium is vacuum, means the speed of photons in air or in vacuum is equal to speed of light. Next, we need to understand this is about the charge on photon. Photons are neutral in nature. We can say photons are neutral, or if you want to say they have no charge. Photons are neutral in nature. So very important point you need to understand. Next thing we need to understand is how we can calculate energy of photon. Energy of photon is simply is equal to HF, or we can write down this is equal to HC over lambda, and this lambda is the wavelength of light, or this is wavelength of photon. So this is wavelength of photon, or we can say this is wavelength of light. So this is very important. Next thing we need to understand, how we can calculate momentum of photon, means how we can calculate P, and momentum of photon, this is equal to H over lambda, and this lambda is the wavelength of photon, or you can say this is wavelength of light. This is how you can calculate. The next point we need to understand, this is about energy of photon, and energy of photon does not depend on intensity of light. Very important concept means very important property of photon. Energy of photon is independent of intensity. We can say energy of photon does not depend on intensity of light. Very important point. Does not depend on intensity of light. Depend on intensity of light, or it is independent of intensity of light. Very important point. A lot of questions you will see in past papers on this property. Also, we need to understand energy of photon, it depends on frequency of light, and it depends on the wavelength of light. So these properties are very important to answer a lot of questions on quantum physics, especially the last one. This is very important. Means energy of photon is independent of intensity of light. For part B, it is given to us a stationary nucleus of samarium 157 emits a gamma ray photon of energy 0.57 mega electron volts. Means energy of photon is given to us. Question is asking us determine for one gamma ray photon what is wavelength of photon. We have already discussed here how to find energy of photon. Energy of photon E is equal to hc over lambda. But for this question, we need to calculate value of lambda. Simply, we can rearrange this one and we can write down the lambda. This will be equal to hc divided by E. And this is energy of single photon. H is Planck's constant, and the value of Planck's constant is equal to 6.63 times 10 to negative 34. And C is a constant, and it is equal to speed of light. So this is 3.0 times 10 to 8 meters per second. Energy of photon is given, but this energy is given in electron volts. We need to convert this energy into joules. We understand one electron volt, this is equal to 1.60 times 10 to negative 19 joules. We have to use this. Means we need to convert electron volts into joules, but this is given in mega electron volts. It simply means this is 0.57 times 10 to 6, and now we need to multiply with 1.60 times 10 to negative 19. Now simply you need to calculate. If you calculate, your final answer will be in this case 2.2 times 10 to negative 12 meter. Then this is the answer for this question up to 2 SF, because our data, the least number of SF in our data is 2 SF. So here you can see least number of SF in our data is 2 SF. So our final answer, we can also write up to 2 SF. So this is our final answer for this question. Let me explain to you how marks will be awarded for this. There are 2 marks for this question. The first mark is if you have written this formula, means if you have used this equation, you will get 1 mark. So this mark will be C mark. And the second mark is answer mark. If you have got the right answer, you will get 2 marks for this question. For part B2, we need to calculate momentum of photon. And momentum of photon is equal to h over lambda, wavelength. And this is wavelength of photon. In the previous part, we have calculated lambda, and the value of the lambda was 2.2 times 10 to negative 12 meters. Now simply we need to divide Planck's constant, its value is 6.63 times 10 to negative 34. We need to divide by lambda, and the value of the lambda we have calculated in part 1. That is equal to 2.2 times 10 to negative 12. Now if we simply solve this one, the value of momentum will be 3.0 times 10 to negative 22 newton seconds, and this is momentum. And this question has 2 marks. The first mark is if you have written this formula, for writing this formula. So this is C mark. If you have got this right answer, you will get 2 marks. Let's try to calculate momentum of photon using a little different method. Momentum of photon, this is also equal to energy of photon divided by the speed of photon, or you can simply say speed of light. E is energy of single photon. So E here for energy of photon. So this is energy of single photon. And C is speed of photon, or you can simply understand this is speed of light, and its value is 3.0 × 10⁸ meters per second. Now for this question, we have energy of photon, so simply we need to divide by C. We need to convert mega electron volts into joules. So simply again we can write down this is energy of photon. This is given in mega electron volts, so we need to multiply with 10⁶. Again we need to multiply with 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁹, because 1 electron volt is equal to 1.60 × 10⁻¹⁹ joules. Just simply divide by speed of photon, or speed of light. Our final answer again will be equal to 3.0 × 10⁻²⁰ newton second. And this is our final answer. Sometimes maybe this approach will be very handy to calculate momentum of photon. For part C1, we need to use answer from part B2 to determine the speed of the samarium 157 nucleus after emission of the photon. It is also given to us the samarium 157 nucleus, initially it was at rest. So we can simply sketch here, this is samarium 157 nucleus. So simply I will write down, this is nucleus. Initially it was at rest, so its initial velocity was zero and its initial momentum of the system was also zero. After it emit photon, we can re-scan this one, what is happening after emission of photon. Let's say photon is emitted to the right, and this photon has certain momentum that we have already calculated, and value of that momentum was 3.00 × 10⁻²⁰ newton second. In order to conserve momentum, this nucleus has to move in the opposite direction but with the same momentum. Means the magnitude of the momentum has to be same, and that magnitude has to be equal to 3.00 × 10⁻²⁰. So now we have momentum of nucleus, we can write down P is equal to mv. Momentum of nucleus in this case is given, that is 3.00 × 10⁻²⁰ newton seconds. It is given to us its samarium nucleus, so we can find out the mass of the nucleus. And mass of nucleus will be equal to number of nucleons you need to multiply by 1.66 × 10⁻²⁷ kg. So this is mass of samarium nucleus. We need to find the speed, so simply we need to rearrange. So this is recoil speed, so we also need to understand this nucleus will recoil, so this speed is also called recoil speed. We need to calculate, so simply we can solve this one by dividing this momentum by the mass of the nucleus. We have momentum, we have mass of nucleus, simply we need to solve this one to calculate speed of nucleus. So speed of nucleus in this case will be equal to 1.2 × 10³ meters per second. And that's the answer. This question has 2 marks, and the first mark will be awarded for correct value of the mass. Means if you have multiplied 157 with 1.66 × 10⁻²⁷, you will get 1 mark, and this is C mark. And the final mark is answer mark. If you have calculated right value of the speed, you will get this answer mark. This is how marks will be awarded. For part C2, we need to explain why the speed of the samarium 157 nucleus may be assumed to be negligible compared with the speed of the photon. Speed of nucleus we have calculated in part C1. Question is also telling us we need to use that speed as a reference. And speed of nucleus, simply we can write down speed of nucleus is 1.2 times 10 to 3 meters per second. And speed of photon in air or vacuum, this is equal to speed of light. Or simply we can say this is equal to 3.0 times 10 to 8 meters per second. Now simply we can find the ratio between these two and then we can conclude. Speed of photon, first of all, let me write down speed of photon and we divide by speed of nucleus. Speed of photon is 3 times 10 to 8 meters per second and the speed of nucleus, this is 1.2 times 10 to 3 meters per second. So roughly this is equal to 10 to 5. Means the speed of photon is 10 to 5 times greater than speed of nucleus. That's reason we can say this speed is negligible as compared with speed of photon. So we can say the speed of nucleus is negligible as compared with speed of photon. So this is negligible because speed of photon is 10 to 5 times, means 100,000 times greater than speed of nucleus. If you write down this much, you will get one mark. Or simply you can say the speed of photon is much, much greater than speed of nucleus. You will get one mark.